Hello students, now we are going to begin the next important small topic which is very important, pedigree analysis. So problems related to pedigree analysis will be asked in the NEET examination, even in the theory examination. So it carry weightage. Definition is also very important. Sometime it will be given in the examination. What is pedigree analysis? We have to define it, and there are some inheritance pattern we are going to discuss today. That is related to pedigree analysis. The inheritance pattern related to pedigree analysis. Let us define first to understand all the aspect related to pedigree analysis. It is very important to understand the definition of a pedigree analysis means what? Let us define it. So, but before going to start the definition, let me give you some information about that introduction to pedigree analysis. See, after the rediscovery of Mendel's work, the practice of analyzing inheritance pattern of traits in human beings started. And since it is evident that the control crosses that can be performed in a pea plant, some other organism, are not possible in case of human. Okay, so it means that as a Mendel has crossed the pea plant by controlling the crosses, but it is not possible in case of human. Okay, the study of family history. So then what exactly the pedigree means, let us understand. The study of the family history about the inheritance of a particular trait, and that provides the alternative. Such an analysis of a trait in and several generation of a family, that is called pedigree analysis. So let me clear this meaning of this explanation. So here, pedigree analysis means what? So it is a family history. So we analyze the family history about the inheritance of particular character. So in a family, this is also called as family tree. So in a family, we analyze the character. It's a method of, it is a method in which we study the inheritance, that is, analyze the what type of character is found in a particular family. Analysis word is very important here. So we analyze the particular trait. That trait may be anything, that trait may be in the form of disease. Okay, that trait may be in the form of disease or any abnormality. So by using pedigree analysis, what we do, we analyze the inheritance of character. Inheritance of, that is character or trait, forward several generation in a family, that is called as pedigree analysis. So our motto is here to find out, to analyze the character or a trait in a family. If a family having any disease or any abnormality, by this tool we can easily find out the what type of inheritance is there, what type of disease is there. So this is a very important method of analyzing the trait. That's all. Okay. So let me define it. It is an analysis of a inheritance of traits or characters forward several generation. We can analyze it. If any person, if a family have any defect, any disease, that can be analyzed by this method, this tool, that is called as pedigree analysis. So as I told, it is a most important and it is very strong tool, an instrument also you can call, it's an instrument or a tool which is utilized to trace the inheritance of a particular character or a disease. So this is a key point. Analysis, this provides a tool for the analysis of a particular trait or disease. This is nothing but a pedigree analysis. Means all this pedigree analysis started after the rediscovery of Mendel's work. That is, the practice of analyzing the inheritance pattern started. Okay. Now, that is in human genetics, pedigree analysis that is going to provide the strong tool. Okay, so which is then utilized to trace the inheritance of a character or any abnormality. Okay, now here some symbols are written on the board. So what these symbols are, they are explaining, what they are indicating, let us understand. So these symbols are showing, or they are used, these symbols are utilized in the human pedigree analysis. How to analyze any trait, how to analyze any character or any abnormality. What is the main source for the analyzing the disease? So here there are some symbols. By using these symbols, we can analyze the type of the trait, the type of the character the individual have in a family. So without the background, without this knowing these symbols, we cannot understand the pedigree analysis. How we analyze any trait, it is not possible. It is possible only by understanding the symbols. So let us understand the meaning of these symbols. And these symbols, already they are mentioned in our NCERT reader on page number 88. On page number 88 NCERT, the figure number 5.13, there the symbols are given already. So let me tell you the meaning of these symbols. What these symbols are specifying? First symbol here, square box, you can see empty square box. Okay, there is no any shade, nothing, it's empty. So this square indicating that is male, the sex is male. Circle without any shade, that is showing female. Then here this structure, sex is not specified, whether it is female or male, it is not clearly, it is not specified. So here three symbols shaded, square, circle and this rectangular shape. So all these individuals are affected. Shaded portion shows affected person or affected children. Okay. So this is the meaning of affected individual. Shading showing affected individual. This is square and two parallel lines attached with the circle. So what does it mean? It means that male, this is a mating between male and female. And this horizontal two lines are showing, no? So this is, that indicates the mating among the close related. So in sometime marriages are done in order to, marriage can be done among the two close relatives. Likewise here, the mating between the relatives, close relative, male mates with the female, that is male person, male and female mating among the between the close relatives. Okay, close relatives. Next, this symbol, what it is showing? So the first one is father, mother, both are parents, do not have any shading, means they do not showing any disease. If they would have shown any shaded portion, means it means that what would it indicate? It would indicate that they are affected individuals. But right now there is no any shading, nothing, empty, both are empty. Both are empty means father, mother, both are parents are normal persons. They are not having any disease. But after that here, to these parents, two children are born. Two children, how they are? Both are, one is female baby, other is male. So male and female, circle is showing female baby, square showing male child. So the children born to these parents, how they are? They are normal. They are not showing any disease. Understood? They are not showing any disease. Means they are normal, it means. Last diagram, last symbol, what it indicates, let us see. Here male circle is female. Both are perfectly normal, both the parents are normal. But there is one child, male child, born to these two parents. That male child is showing some shaded portion. It means what? The male child is not normal. It is affected with some disease. Some disease, it may be anything, any genetical disease it may be showing. So this affected male child born to this normal male, normal parents. So both the parents are normal. They are showing showing normal character, means they do not showing any disease. But the child which is male born to this parent is, it is not normal. Instead, it is affected with some disease. So if you understand these symbols meaning, we can understand the cross. Okay, so we can understand the pedigree analysis. Okay, so because in the examination also you should understand, you should be able to identify the symbol. If the male is, if a square means male, circle means female, shaded means affected, empty means normal, like that. So if you understand the meaning of all these symbols, it is very easy to work out the problems or easily identify. You can identify the pedigree analysis. So sometime what type of questions will be asked in the examination, I will show you after this, after the explanation of a pedigree analysis. I will show you what type of questions will be, question will be framed based on this pedigree analysis later on. But according to our NCERT reader, there are some two diseases which are related to pedigree analysis. In the next video, I will show you, I will explain you regarding those pedigree analysis diseases. Those pedigree analysis are related to some diseases. So those diseases we are going to discuss. Okay, we will stop here.